just wanted to give you guys a quick reminder. If you guys love my videos and want to support me, check out compassion-tees.com. Link is at the end of the video. All right, this is John Cole with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. And you know, one of the challenges that I get here in the springtime, and maybe you guys do too in the spring or maybe other times of the year, is you get soft-bodied insects landing on your crops. This time of year, I actually have aphids. My brassicas are in the flowering stage, so the aphids love to land in a little brassica flower, broccoli, before they pre-emerge and blow up into flowers. And even after they blow into flowers, the aphids love to sit on there and literally suck their juice out so that they can live. And, you know, some people might get out like some Neem and Dr. Bronner's, which I had advocated in the past, but I want to encourage you guys to do a less toxic, you know, even organic applications of any kind of sprays or even organic pesticides in your garden, right? These and any kind of even organic sprays can negatively impact beneficials, including beneficial pollinators, beneficial insects, and, you know, potentially even beneficial bacteria and microbes and life in your garden. So I have other episodes on this. I'll put a couple links down below to some other non-toxic methods of controlling insects without spraying. But one of the ways I've been doing that is this guy. This is actually called the Bug Blaster. And it basically is just a little tip that you put on your hose, and you can just spray this. And what happens is, as you guys can see, it sprays out basically high pressure water. And what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to take this and put it right into the plants where the bugs are. And the high pressure water basically blasts off, discombobulates. Wait, can aphids be discombobulated? You know, mealybugs, whiteflies, discombobulates the soft-bodied insects. Even spider mites will discombobulate them, you know, fatally traumatize them. And actually, this method is actually quite effective. The challenge with that is that, you know, sometimes I don't like to spray high pressure water in the middle of the day on my plants, so I gotta wait till the morning or the evening. The other thing is that when you do this sprayer, like, I get in some shorts like I'm gonna go to the beach, because let me tell you guys, the water gets everywhere. And if you guys don't want to get a bug blaster, I've also used just a standard, you know, a sprayer with like a nice fan spray that like sprays hard. I just basically use my hand to back up the leaf and I just spray it on there, you know, to spray the bugs off. Basically cleaning my leaves at the same time it dislodges them and discombobulates them. So that's the recommended way. But I saw this item on clearance at Home Depot, and I'm a clearance whore. Wait, is that even a word, or should I even call myself that? Is that bad or good? Well, anyways, I like buying things on clearance if and only if I can use it and if it'll be useful. So when I see an item on clearance, I'm like, okay, I ask myself, John, do you really need this item? Is it going to significantly change your life? And if I answer it's not going to significantly change my life, then I must resist and I walk away from the clearance item. I keep the money in my pocket instead of buying and getting the rush of, cool, I got this item for super cheap, right? So I saw this item on clearance, and actually what it is, it's a Ryobi. No, it's not my drill. I'm not going to drill my plants to kill the bugs. But what we will be doing is we will be using a lithium ion 18-volt battery pack here, the OnePlus battery pack, on this item, which is actually called, and there's stickers all over the box, thanks to Home Depot. It's actually called the 18-volt high-volume power inflator. So this is what it looks like. There's only one left, so I was kind of lucky. And so what this thing does, this is designed if you have like guests coming over, like your mother-in-law, maybe your father-in-law, right? And you don't have a spare bedroom, you gotta like pump up an inflatable bed or something like that, you know, or you got them big, I don't know, jump houses or something for your kids. This is a power inflator that works on that battery there. So it was actually on clearance for $7 and change. I'll let you guys know the item number here. Let me see here. SKU number 100230-9571. Once again, 100230-9571. This may or may not be on clearance at your local Home Depot. Some stores may have them on clearance and others may still have them at full price. So you never know. Luckily, I found a store in town that had it. So anyways, what this does, you put the battery on there, then you can just press this. And basically it blows high pressure air out of here. And you know, I want to funnel that air. So basically we have this attachment piece, and we're gonna put this on, and I want to show you guys actually how I could literally use this as a blower to blow off my patio. So let's see if this will work to blow off my patio. We just opened a coconut here, so I got some coconut fibers, probably some dust, and watch closely. Oh, look at that. It's blowing it away pretty good. All the small particles and stuff have a nice clean surface, but let's see if this guy will also blow away my bugs. What you guys are looking at now are my purple, mostly tree collards that are now flowering and also going to seed, and then I got some green ones that are a little bit late blooming. We're gonna try to blast off my aphids that are forming right up in this little top area, right where the flowers form. But instead of just using the standard blower right here, which is what you'd use for an inflatable, they have this little piece down here that's attached to the bottom that basically you lift up and suck out or pull out. Oops, and I dropped it. And what that is, that's a little cone here that then you put on the tip here, so now it directs the beam or the airflow right through these two little holes here. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna basically put this right near the aphids and turn this on high and basically run it up and down and around and blast them off. So we're gonna go ahead and give you guys a close up to see if you guys can see the aphids being blasted off. And hopefully we'll even be able to do this in slow-mo. Hopefully you guys can see all the little buggers right on here. It's all the little gray things on here, basically aphids. Depending on what juice they're sucking, they might turn green, they might turn gray, they might turn kind of white. And once again, I'm recommending this only for soft-bodied insects. I don't think it's gonna work on any hard-bodied ones like scale. This ain't gonna do nothing to scale. But these guys, let's take a look. You guys could see this before, and we're just gonna run this up. It's gonna get a little bit loud, but watch these guys, and we'll try to do it in slow-mo for you guys. All right, look at that, man. Nice and clean. I see no more aphids. This thing was 100% effective. I think it's really cool. You can't just put it on there and blow it. You gotta run it up and down and all this kind of stuff. But man, this is actually kind of fun. If I had kids, I'd give them this and let them run around the yard and get all my aphids for me so that I don't have to. I wanna give you guys another demonstration. The other one's pretty easy because the aphids were pretty easy to access. Sometimes aphids get in there and they're hiding like underneath the baby leaves and all whatnot. So we're gonna go ahead and try this again here. Once again, my green tree collards. You can see the aphids up on the stem, and generally they like to hatch their eggs right on the new baby leaves, which are nice and tender for them to suck in their little vampire fangs or whatever they have and suck your plant juices out, which basically in the long run brings the health of your plant down. So let's get rid of these buggers with our Ryobi Inflator. All right, 1, 2, 3, we'll do slow-mo for you guys. Look at that now, man, nice and clean. I think this tool is completely amazing. So far, so good. This Ryobi Inflator tool is working really well. If you guys saw like the last episode or maybe two episodes ago, I had an episode on Dr. Zymes, which is a great spray you could buy, which actually I used on my lettuce, which I think pretty much helped a lot. Let me see if I see any aphids down in there, but this tool is kind of cool because you can kind of get into the base, right, really easily. And blow them down. So like, looks like to me that this thing really blows. Hey, I like things that can really blow. So anyways, I want to give you guys my final thoughts on the Inflator tool that's now on clearance, maybe near you for $7 and some change. I don't know, $7.86 or $7.90 something. I don't know. So number one, I think this is like the best $7 I ever spent at Home Depot on my garden. Number one, I get incredible joy blowing these buggers off my plants. Like, that is like uber cool, right? And I know some of you guys out there, John, like, I'm vegan, man. Like, I don't want to hurt insects. So, you know, in my opinion, it's either them or me. Either I'm eating my food or they're eating my food. And in my opinion, bugs that visit my garden, they are freeloaders, right? They're freeloading, sucking the juice sap, taking the health of my plants down, taking nutrients away that should be going into me, right? So I don't have any problems blowing them off. That being said, when I was blowing them off, some would blow off and land on me and I'd feel them walking and I could see them walking on me. So some may stay alive. So this is the chance you're gonna take with this device. It may not kill them all. You may be relocating them, but chances are, you know, if they're basically disconnected from their food source, they may not be able to find another food source. Who knows where they fly? You know, they might end up on the ground. Some kind of other insects are gonna eat them, you know. But anyways, this is a non-toxic way to just get them off your plants. Once they're off your plants could have a chance to, you know, recover, regrow, do well. Also, I like that even on soft lettuces, right, that are generally pretty tender, this doesn't damage the lettuce. Like if I did that, you know, the bug blast or the high pressure water, like that would like damage my lettuce. Like sometimes I've done that and my leaves are damaged by high pressure water. So this does not damage your plants. I mean, if you're growing cannabis, whatever else, even in an indoor grow, I think this is one excellent way to dislodge them. Maybe use this in combination with something else. In addition, the other thing I like about this is that this is a one-time purchase, right? Unlike the Dr. Zymes where you could buy a bottle, a quart, whatever you guys get, you could spray it, it's gone. You have to actually rebuy it. This, you buy it once, you just keep recharging your battery, you can just keep using it. It runs out of battery, charge another one. I got actually two batteries in the kit that I bought. So I could literally go all day blasting off bugs with the power of air on my garden, non-toxic. You're like, John, I don't have the OnePlus system with the batteries. Well, then you gotta buy one of these and it kinda gets more expensive. But I'd say it's still worth it, you know? But if you guys already have these batteries, then it's definitely worth it to spend the $7. My final comment is I've often thought about using like a high pressure air compressor, you know, and spraying the plants down. I guess you can regulate the air pressure on a air compressor so you don't spray too hard, because literally you'll probably poke holes through some leaves if you spray, you know, 100 PSI or whatever. And so that would probably work pretty well. The challenge with that is that your air compressor might not be portable. Whereas this one, you could take it out in the field, you could take it to the North 40, you could take it to the moon with you if you wanted. As long as you got a charge on the battery that you could probably charge with the solar panels, you are good to go. So at this point, for one of the best alternative methods for controlling aphids and other soft-bodied insects, including whiteflies, mealybugs in your garden, this inflation tool is definitely the best. It has my approval. Hope you guys enjoyed this short format episode. If you guys like this episode, me going out on a limb, sharing my crazy ideas. I mean, you will not find this on any other gardening channel, and I appreciate you guys that have watched it to the end. This is what my gardening channel is about. It's about my journey of growing food so I can have the healthiest food, so I could eat the food, so I could have the highest level of health possible, because I almost lost my life when I was younger. It's not about gardening on the free, gardening on the cheap. It's gardening in the most natural, biologic way to grow the highest quality food and hurting the earth the least. And in my opinion, this does it the least. And I want to encourage you guys always to make the least toxic decisions first. And of course, you know, you got your fingers there. You could always sit there and smush aphids when you see them. The problem with that is they get your fingers really gross and nasty. And the other thing is you can't get in between the leaves into these little buds, right? The pubescent buds before they open to spray out all the aphids. But guess what? With the power of air, you now can. So this video was not sponsored in any way. I went and bought this at Home Depot. And I want to try to see if this works. And I'd like to share with you guys actually my journey doing things outside the box, because I have no horticulture degree. I didn't learn how to garden until I was like, you know, more mature in life. And, you know, I just try to do things that are more practical. So anyways, if you guys like this video, want more like this, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Also be sure to share this video in different, you know, gardening Facebook groups or online with your other gardening friends and all of your gardening clubs, so that they could learn a new way to prevent bugs organically and get them off their plants in their garden. Also be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss any of my new and upcoming episodes. I've come out every 3 to 4 days in Render Worship, where we'll be learning on my YouTube channel. And make sure you click the little bell so you get notified as my videos come out. You wouldn't want to miss any cool new gadget that I get to buy on clearance, all right? And then finally, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge over 1,400 episodes at this time, and based on my subscriber count, which is now approaching 600,000 subscribers now on YouTube, which is the most watched YouTube gardener, I think people do find me of value, and I hope that you guys would too. So with that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and until then, remember, keep on growing.